Today we are going to talk about what do you as a person like to do for your hobbies, at school, etc. This is the very beginning lessons of chapitre 2 in your book Bien dit, and for those of you following along in your book, it is page 40. So the first thing we're going to talk about really quickly here, as we learned in chapter 1, to form a sentence in French, you always have a subject followed by a verb, and you have to conjugate the verb, which means to change it, so that it matches each different subject, which is really important. So that's going to come into play really quickly here in chapter 2, because we're going to start using sentences that say that you like or don't like to do something, whether you like or don't like an item. So that's really important that we have to know to change our verb to match our subject pronoun, to conjugate it as we always have done. And then one of the first rules we're going to talk about really quickly here is that you can only conjugate one verb in a row in French. You can't have two verbs conjugated right in a row. So, whenever you have a verb that's conjugated or changed to match the subject, the next verb, if you're going to use a verb, has to be an infinitive. And an infinitive is a verb that has two plus the action. Like the verb avoir that you learned, the verb avoir meant to have. And then when you changed it to j'ai, tu as, il a, elle a, that was when it meant I have, you have, he has, she has. So we are going to use both conjugated verbs and infinitives in this first lesson. I'm going to show you some example sentences and how we're going to say some of these vocabulary words, and then we'll go through all of the different activities that you can like or not like to do. So I labeled these sentences just like we label them in class. So what we have here, we have a sentence, for example, that says, tu aimes chanter, tu aimes chanter. And this is a question using intonation, so just using our voice. And here we have the word M. M is going to be like. So this sentence says, you like, and then chante, you guys know, is to sing. So this says, you like to sing. So here I've labeled for you, our subject is tu. The verb is M, like, which is changed. It's conjugated to match tu, so you like tu M. And then as you can see, what I was just talking about is that our next verb, chanter, is not conjugated to match tu. It's an infinitive. It says to sing. So this sentence translates directly to English. Tu aimes chanter, you like to sing. So that's what a lot of our sentences are going to look like in this chapter. Now, you could also, if you want, follow tu aimes with an object. So for example, tu aimes le tableau? Do you like the board in the classroom? Tu aimes le poster? Do you like the poster? That would be fine. But when you follow it with an action, it needs to be a verb that is not conjugated. So if you follow tu aimes, you like, with an action, you don't conjugate the verb. You don't change it at all. Just use it to sing. So some other examples of ways you can respond, you can say, oui, j'aime chanter. J'aime chanter. And check out, I've labeled here our subject and verb as we do in class. Subject is the J, je, which has an apostrophe because of this vowel that this verb starts with. J'aime chanter. I like to sing. So you can see M again, which is like, and you'll notice that there's no S on it like there is of tu, and that's because this is M conjugated for je. J'aime chanter. So to say you like something, you say j'aime. This word right here, j'aime, which means I like, j'aime. So you can follow that. You can say j'aime chanter, I like to sing, or any other action. Or you can say j'aime le poster, I like the poster, if that works. As we learned in chapter 1, you can also make this verb negative. You can use the ne pas that we used in class to make the verb negative. You can say je n'aime pas chanter, I do not like to sing. So as you guys can see, the verb aime, still conjugated for je, has the ne pas around it, and that makes it negative. It makes it mean I do not like. And then you can follow it with your action, chanter, or you can follow it with a noun, je n'aime pas le poster. I don't like the poster. A new word we're going to hear here, je déteste chanter. Déteste is like the English word detest, which in French means to hate. So je déteste chanter, I hate to sing. So you have here, je déteste chanter. I hate, déteste, hate, being conjugated for je, and chanter, to sing, the infinitive, okay? You can also say, instead of saying that you hate to do something, you can say, je déteste le poster, I hate the poster, whatever object you want to hate. Now, the really important question that we are going to learn in this chapter is this question. Qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire? Qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire? So that's the question. I'm going to peek out and see you guys here. Hello. So this is the question on the bottom of my board here. Qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire? And it's also in the bottom of your page 41 in your book in the blue box. Qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire? So qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire means what do you like to do? And I'm going to show you the parts of speech on this question again just so you understand where they're all coming from. You have que here, which means what. This word est-ce, which is a really long word, est-ce, which we say a lot in French, especially when we ask questions, and we'll get into that in chapter 2, but it has no English translation. All est-ce is like a light bulb going off in your head, like ding, 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 ooh, I heard the word est-ce, that means somebody's asking me a question. It has no translation in English, it doesn't mean anything. It's just like a ding, 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 oh my gosh, a question is coming, I should be on the alert to answer. So you have the question word what, then est-ce, which signals this is a question. Qu'est-ce que tu, there's your subject, you, aime, there's your verb again, like, and then we use the infinitive faire, which means to do. Qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire? And faire you'll see a lot in this chapter. Qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire? You can also stop the question short. You can take out faire and just say, qu'est-ce que tu aimes? What do you like? Or you can say, qu'est-ce que tu aimes faire? What do you like to do? So again, you can use the word j'aime to say I like. You can also say j'adore, which is in page 41 of your book, j'adore, which means I love. Or you can say j'aime bien, which is like I really like, j'aime bien, and then whatever activity you like to do. So that's basically the gist of the vocab for this section. We are going to go through all of the different activities, though, if you want to follow along in page 40, 41 of your book, Bien dit. It's on these two pages here, these two pages. And we're just going to go through each activity and each object that goes with them. If we're going to start on page 40, we have j'aime le chocolat, which is chocolate. J'aime les frites, which is French fries. J'aime la glace is ice cream. J'aime un crayon ou un crayon de couleur. Un crayon just means a pencil, not a crayon. Un crayon de couleur means a colored pencil, not a crayon. Un dessin means a drawing or a design. And then the verbs for those two activities, dessiner, dessiner means to draw, and manger, manger means to eat. If you go down to the next picture, you have l'école. Moi, j'aime l'école. L'école means school, l'école, school. And you have lire, j'adore lire. Lire means to read, to read. Things you can read, un journal means a newspaper, not a journal. Un journal is a newspaper. Un roman means a novel, usually a fiction novel for un roman. Un magazine is a magazine, as you probably could guess. Une bande dessinée, or une bande dessinée can be shortened to une BD, the abbreviation, une BD, which is a comic book. And then à l'école, at school, you can like les mathématiques, which is math, le français, which is French, or l'anglais, l'anglais is English. Okay, so that is page 40. And then over here on the other page, 41, we have a couple other activities that you can like. You can say, j'aime écouter de la musique. Écouter de la musique, which is to listen to music. And things that go with music are les écouteurs, which are earphones, and le baladeur, which is iPod. You can say, téléphoner. Téléphoner means to make phone calls. You can say, téléphoner à des amis. Téléphoner à des amis means to call your friends. You can say, chanter, as we had in the example, which is to sing. Surfer sur Internet. Surfer sur Internet, which means to surf the Internet, to be on the Internet. You can say la musique moderne. J'aime la musique moderne. I like modern music. J'aime la radio. La radio is the radio. J'aime la musique classique. La musique classique is classical music. And then our favorite thing to do in class, of course, envoyer des SMS, ou envoyer des textos, which is text messaging, to send a text I like to say envoyer des textos. SMS is, I don't love that abbreviation, so I say envoyer des textos. Or envoyer un email, which we all know how to ask for somebody's email address, so there you go. Other things you can like, les vacances, which are vacation, les vacances. La voiture du sport, le voiture de sport is a sports car. Dormir, dormir is to sleep. Travailler, travailler, which means to work, not to travel. A lot of people can choose that one. Travailler means to work. Étudier, étudier is to study, just like an étudiant. Parler français, parler means to talk, parler. Donc parler français, speak French, parler anglais, speak English. Regarder la télé ou regarder la télévision. Ouais. All right, and you can also, if you really want to look for more things you can talk about, more things to like, more school subjects, in the back of your book, there's a page called R10, and you can look up some more things to like there, especially school subjects, if you want to talk about a specific school subject that you like. Okay, so that's pretty much all of our vocabulaire pour aujourd'hui. Donc, à demain et bonne chance avec le devoir!